Welcome to the Alabama Quick Start Guide for 2011, where I am here. I'm Casey Graham, and I am the 4 to 5, is it 4 months or 5 months? How long do they play football?
It's 4 months.
4 months out of the year kind of fan.
Five if you count.
Five fall if you practice. Count fall practice, which is 36 days, 14 hours, and 47 minutes and 13 seconds before kickoff. And
that's
so
right.
This is the kind of, when I start getting into it, you know, there's a lot of people out there like that. They're probably watching this video. And then there's people like you. So
that's
tell
right.
them a little bit about you, Louie.
I pretty much have a problem. I'm obsessed. I mean, I read something about Alabama football in March, April, May, June, all year round, 365.
So basically, you love your wife.
Yep.
Your child.
Yes.
In Alabama football.
That is very true.
That's good. All right. Well, I'm glad that your priorities are very clearly identified. And if you're on the list and you thought you were a priority, you're not. So, let's just take a look here. What we're going to talk about is the quarterback position.
Okay.
Nobody wants to listen to a long video on a bunch of things, but people want to know about the quarterback. What do people need to know out there about the quarterback situation this year? Because I'm going to tell you from my perspective, it's just kind of a – I don't know what I'm considered. I'm just kind of I'm not fair weather because I pull every year.
Right.
But, I'm not into the details and all that kind of stuff. But here's the way I look out. The way I look at it is that we're pretty much screwed.
We pretty much are. We lost a great guy in Greg McElroy that gave us two great years. Won a national championship and SEC ring. And played
just,
great.
And what we talked about in between these videos is that he had a history of winning. It's like he had at least a story or something to talk about and came from a football family.
Sure.
His dad
is in the front office for the Dallas Cowboys. He sat and waited behind Chase Daniel at his high school in Texas, who Chase Daniel ended up playing at Missouri. Sat and waited behind him until his senior year and then went undefeated and won a state championship at the highest level of football in Texas.
See, here's where the sickness is. That's sick.
That is sick, but that is true.
But that's true. And so now we find ourselves in a situation. When I look at our quarterback, look at this right here. Look at this.
Yeah.
It's freshman, sophomore, freshman.
Yeah, absolutely. And if you go back all the way up to the top of the page, the guy that's listed as athlete there, Blake Sims, he's also practicing with the quarterbacks.
Okay.
And he's from right here in Gainesville, Georgia.
Well, I thought it was Gainesville, Florida. I was about to say, the best decision anybody can make is leaving Gainesville.
No, he's here in Gainesville, Florida, the chicken capital of the South.
Chicken capital.
That's right.
But Gainesville, Florida is the chicken capital?
I'm sorry, Gainesville, Georgia.
It's chicken capital.
Yes.
But people that just have great coaches that fall apart overnight, it just seems to be in Florida.
Absolutely.
What happened to that guy?
I don't know.
Urban Meyer just went down the tubes.
1 minute he wins a national championship, next minute
he quit, and then
out.
He came back.
And then he came back, and then he quit again.
And then he quit again. Okay.
To spend time with his family while he spends every day at ESPN Studios.
All right, so back to the quarterbacks. Tell us what we got going on, our situation here. We got Philip Ealy, AJ McCarron, Morgan
Ogilvy,
which is from an Ogilvy.
Major Ogilvy.
Who was a running back in the 70s?
Yes, for Alabama. Yes. So he's got some family.
For some reason, I'm sure that had nothing to do with him making the Alabama football team.
I'm sure it
being
did
from
not.
Mountain Brook. And his name is Morgan?
Yes.
It should be, what we talk about, William or...
Yeah.
If you're from Mountain Brook,
your name should either be William or Edward. That's it.
Okay, so Philip Sims, that's our rundown. So who's going to start?
If we played this coming Saturday, our starter would absolutely be AJ McCarron. Just because he's a redshirt sophomore as opposed to Philip Sims being a redshirt freshman. He's got a little more time in the system. He actually does have some game experience, even though it was all in mop-up duty. And they finished the spring pretty much neck and neck. I mean, it was crazy. I don't know if you saw, not only did they pretty much the same amount of yards in the 8A game, but when you looked at all three scrimmages of the spring and added them all together, I think they were like 1 through for 780 yards and 1 through for 787 yards or something.
That's
like that.
That's where the sickness is.
Yes.
Now, all I remember of A.J. McCarron is his fantastic pass when we were winning 30-3 against Mississippi State.
Yes.
Which was really a terrible pass. He didn't do any reads. He just threw the ball up.
He just threw it 50 yards down the field.
And ran off the field, and Nick Saban chewed him.
And then spanked him. spanked him on national television.
He spanked him hard. I'm talking about it, but if you're going to get spanked by somebody, Nick Saban's a good guy to get spanked by.
I totally agree.
Nick Saban's a good spanker. Okay. And then we got Phillip Sims.
Yeah, Phillip Sims, along with A.J. McCarron, they were both top 10 quarterbacks coming out of high school. Phillip Sims was, even according to Rivals, the number one quarterback coming out of high school in his recruiting class, although they said it was one of the worst years for quarterbacks in the last several years. So I don't know how much that says. But these guys both have the talent. They both have big arms. And it's just really going to come down. I mean, Saban said it himself, it's just going to come down to who plays better in the games. We're going to see both of these guys, to be honest.
Are we going to do the flip-flop thing?
I definitely think we will for the first two or three games.
I'm not even afraid.
We're going to play both of them. He's basically said at media days he's not afraid to do that, and he's going to do that.
So he was from Oscar Smith. I had a cat named Oscar.
You did have a cat named Oscar. I believe you found him in a Christmas tree farm.
No, at Home Depot.
Oh, at Home Depot.
With... That
but it was great. Under a Christmas tree.
Let me just give you some. If you ever find a kitten and you latches onto your shirt, it's over.
Yeah. Don't take him home.
But I did.
Because that cat was possessed.
And it was over. Yeah. And that didn't work out too well. So that's the quarterback situation.
Yes.
And that's what you need to know. Starting out this year, it's going to be a little fight, a little back and forth. But at the end of the day, we're looking good for the future, but not this year necessarily. However, Jay Barker won it as a sophomore.
He did. Did win he start as a freshman? He did not start as a freshman until about the second or third game when the starter ahead of him got hurt and he couldn't even find his helmet. And he finally somebody got in the game. He played the rest of the season as a freshman, then started as a sophomore.
Okay. Well, my baby upstairs is about to start screaming.
That's right.
So we need to sign off. This is what you need to know. I'm Casey. This is Louie, and Alabama Quick Start Guide 2011.
Roll Tide.